Okay, so here we are on that welcome page. And if I reload this page, we keep seeing the same thing. The last thing I asked you to do is implement logout. So this URL, when you go to it, redirects you to the signup page. And if I were to go back to the welcome page and reload this, it redirects us to the signup page because our cookie's been deleted. The way you log somebody out is you delete their cookie. Now, I didn't say that in the lecture. Hopefully you managed to figure that out. Let's go ahead and see that in action again. Let's log in. You can see we have a cookie. The user ID cookie equals 5. That's the user ID for Spez in this machine. And if I go to log out and we go look at our cookie again, we can see that the user ID cookie is just blank. There's user ID cookie. There's nothing in it. So that's how logout works. Let's look at the code for this. First thing we have is our logout handler. So I map slash logout to the logout handler. When we look at the logout handler, you can see it calls self.logout, which is defined up on blog handler, and then it redirects to signup. And so let's look at this logout function. Here it is. Remember, we are in class blog handler, where I've put all this kind of helpful generic stuff that other handlers may use. And all logout does is it sets the cookie user ID to nothing. So instead of setting cookie equals value, we just set cookie equals nothing, and we keep the same path. So we're setting and overwriting the same cookie. And if we didn't have these path variables here, or this path parameter here on the cookie, we would actually overwrite we might set the cookie on slash login or slash signup, the default URL where you're on. And then when you go to the welcome page, you wouldn't be logged in. So that would cause problems. So we make sure we set the cookie on path slash, and we delete the cookie off of path slash. And so that's how logout works. And if you got all that, you did a very good job. That's one of the more complicated things you do when you're writing web apps, is all this kind of cookie and hashing and all of that manipulation. But it's also, you can start doing some really clever things. And while a lot of frameworks do a lot of this for you, I think it's really important to understand how it works, because you'll often find yourself in a situation where you need to, you know, hide some data in a cookie, maybe have a special type of hash that represents some piece of information and that sort of thing. You know, we do that on Reddit all the time for anti-cheating stuff. And knowing how this all fits together, I think, is really important. That's why I made you do all of this. Good job, and we'll see you next week.